Hello YouTube, my name is Rutger and in this video I'm gonna share a few tricks for arranging a song. And coming up with ideas in FL Studio is quite easy. You put on a few loops or maybe VST instruments and you have a great idea within minutes. But a great idea isn't a complete song, and arranging songs is quite hard, quite difficult to do so. Well, a few tricks to make it more easy. First of all, what you can do is select, let's say, 32 bars and put all of the elements below each other. So a kick, a clap, open hi-hats, percussion, bass, etc. Everything is in there, each track on a separate channel. And now I select the mute tool with the T button. And I can mute and unmute certain parts of this arrangement. So I can say, the kick in the beginning, maybe the clap, extra percussion, put it on or just put it off. Maybe this. Well, I can listen how it sounds when it's on, when it's off. And this way I can mute and unmute certain parts and create a first little arrangement for the first 33 bars of this song. So mute or unmute is a great way to listen to the song, listen to the elements and decide, well, maybe here the bass line shouldn't be here. Let's introduce the bass line here, measure 16, or maybe the step off beat, I can put it in here, or maybe not with the T, click once again. Well, it's a great way to get a rough idea of the arrangement. Second trick is using a reference track, and this is a reference track I found online on YouTube. Put it in the song as well, I can mute it and unmute it. With a reference track you can listen how they arrange their song. It's a commercially released song, so I can listen to how they build up the song, to the breaks, the elements of the tracks, not to steal it. But when I don't have a clue, don't have an idea which way to go with my song, I can listen to this track or maybe another track. You can use 2 or 3 or 4 reference tracks as well, just for inspiration, which way you want your track to develop. You can listen to the reference track and get a rough idea. So it's that's an idea as well. Reference track, you can use 1 or 2 or 3, mute, unmute and listen to them when you don't have a clue which way to go with your song. One final trick you can use is markers, add markers in FL Studio, and you can do so with Alt plus G. But before I insert a marker, I'm first going to make a selection. Now it's going to add a marker at measure 25. So when I put Alt plus T, I can say mental note. I can say this is the final part before the drop, or I can put in something there for myself. You can do so as well while listening to a reference track. Maybe your track is, house music, 122, 124 BPM. You can even steal the setup if you want to of another commercial track. But you can listen. You can listen to where they introduce the main kick or maybe the break. And you can make mental notes as well. I don't like the idea of stealing, but you can do so if you're stuck with your arrangement and you have no clue how to finish your track. But you can add markers this way and get an idea. And one of the things I like about markers is when you know that, for instance, this is the start of the break at measure 57, for instance, I could use add a marker, start of break. And if I'm not inspired in the beginning of the track, I can start with, for instance, the break. And then I know kind of what the break will sound like. And this way it's more easy to work towards the break. So I know, this is where the break starts. The break sounds kind of like this. And, I can make the arrangement towards the break with the kick, with the hi-hats, with the bass. And maybe some elements that are missing, I can add them later on. And, this way you can create your own arrangements. It's hard work, but it pays off. Finishing a track is really a great feeling, I can assure you. So these are my arrangement tricks, 3 of them. First of all, put all your elements below each other on a separate track and use the mute tool with the T button. Second trick, use reference tracks, maybe one, maybe two, maybe three, not to steal them, but just listen to commercially released tracks and decide what you like of the track and which way you can head with your track. And the final trick is use markers, and this way you can decide, okay, this is the beginning of the track, this is the break, maybe I'd like to do something here, something there. You don't have to start at the beginning of the track, you can start, for instance, with the break or with the build-up or even with the end part of the song if you like. But with markers you have the structure in place and then you can fill in the gaps. So these are my arrangement tricks for FL Studio. Good luck and keep on making great music. Bye.